So what are some interesting language developments that are happening at Microsoft? Well, obviously TypeScript. I mean, if you'd asked me 10 years ago, would anybody be excited about JavaScript? I would have been like, hell no. I think Anders and team have done a fabulous job, right? And another one, I'd say in a similar vein, that's really showing up a lot, it's exciting, is Rust. You get the performance benefits of C++, but you get more type safety, right? And I think, in general, you want to fail fast. It's so much better to have the compiler catch problems, right? And then if you can't do that, to crash right away. Why do we have hard asserts in the code? Then to get these highs and bugs, you're never sure what happened or what led up to it. So I think that's pretty fascinating. And in my own team, working on Web OneNote, a lot of that was actually written in something called Script Sharp. It doesn't exist. It was a C-sharp-like language that would generate TypeScript. And it's not maintained, and it's piggy, and it's undebuggable. And so we're making an enormous effort called Project DullScript with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, but being driven by OneNote to get that all into good-looking TypeScript. So that's pretty cool. And then we're big fans of React, React Native for cross-plat things, especially for stuff like Lottie. The design team, you know, can prototype animations. And really, it's just so much easier to prototype in the web, right? Do A/B testing. So anything, unless it's really important, that final mile or for the purpose of the feature, like inking, to not have to worry about, you know, native tied being tied to a particular piece of hardware or a platform. So Rust and React, not really a language, but you know what I mean, and TypeScript.